a couple things that come to mind when I think about secondary education versus elementary education in terms of museum education is that when I'm giving tours to younger students, usually the focus is way more on the kind of critical thinking skills that they can develop from observing and interpreting artworks. Versus secondary school students who I am often trying to give some kind of context to. I'm giving more information on my tours, so versus just, you know, asking them what they notice and what they think is going on in the painting, I will often give them more information about the artist and also the artwork. In this tour that I've just given, actually, I gave a lot of historical context. They were Spanish honor students in an international baccalaureate class, so I gave some information about what was going on during wartime when some still lifes were painted in a Spanish painting show we have here. And they thought about the symbolism of the objects, which is something that younger students, I will have them think about the symbolism of the objects, but often less embedded within the historical and political context, because that might be kind of above their heads at that point. And I really want the tours to be focused, you know, student-centered, so that it's around things that they may already understand, already be thinking about, they're making the meaning on their own, but these students could make some of those kind of larger contextual connections, as well as that kind of just the basic symbolism connections. So that's the first thing. The second thing that I would think is different, especially on a tour like today where we were comparing some Picassos to Goya or Velázquez, is that oftentimes I do this tour stop that I just did today where I will have students compare a Picasso to a Goya. Inevitably when I bring elementary school students and I ask them what are the similarities and differences, they do not bring up anything about style. And I did a little bit of research into that. By that I mean artistic style, like Picasso moving into the more abstract kind of cubist work, whereas it's a very realistic Goya painting. And in my research into child development, I found that actually it is really not until later middle school years, like 8th grade, that students can start to recognize differences in artistic styles. So keeping with that student-centered philosophy, I don't bring artistic style into it until later, until students really are starting to notice it on their own. And in the secondary, at the secondary level, they really do start to, and that becomes much more prominently figured into the tours that I did.
Well, the effects of art plays a major role on children. It allows children to really find out about themselves as an individual. Art is a way to communicate with different cultures and also society, and also I would say the people around them. It allows them to find out about themselves in a natural kind of way. My students have this incredible talent that they don't really realize, but I'm there as a facilitator to bring this talent out, to let them realize what kind of strength and power they have within themselves as an individual. Art allows you to be a critical thinker. It allows you to think about certain situations in a piece that you're working on. How can you improve that piece? What can you do to make this piece have a soul, to live, to give that three-dimensional quality? The artwork that I create, I try to have some type of individuality, something that speaks to you. If it doesn't speak to you in a certain way, if it doesn't have a soul, I would say that piece really doesn't work for you. Art deals with imagination, a lot of color, a lot of discipline, and I would say art takes a lot of commitment. You have to have that commitment and that passion when you create art. And when you deal with reality and the real world, you have to realize you want to share something within yourself, to express yourself in a certain way. And the great thing about art, it allows you to express your inner feelings in a way that many people can't really express. They can express themselves maybe musically, which is painting with words. They can express themselves visually, when it deals with the visual image, either using charcoal or paint. One of the major classes that I teach my students at the Cleveland School of the Arts is anatomy. Anatomy incorporates science, it incorporates measuring, it incorporates, I would say, learn about the structure of the human body. And once we start learning about the anatomy, we can take that to another level with my students. And then after that, we start working on portraits after they learn about anatomy. One thing that art does, it allows you to incorporate sciences, also biology, and I would say other aspects of the academia world. And it brings out our interest in health, an interest in biology. Also, it allows them to think about their artwork in a different form.
You know, receive some early training in grade school. They have to learn some of the basic skills. And, you know, hopefully when, you know, they come to me, I could, you know, take those skills, you know, steps further. You know, here in this school, you know, what I often am doing is teaching some of the basic skills, like one-point perspective, you know, contour drawing, you know, etc. And, you know, what I think is important is, on one hand, is to introduce students, you know, to, you know, the art of different cultures, and on the other hand, to develop their basic skills. And, you know, also to give them experience, you know, in, you know, exploring their own interest and their own potential. They need to, you know, to have the experience of working in different media. You know, they need to learn such simple techniques as mixing colors, you know, using the brush, you know, drawing, you know, three-dimensional objects, you know, on two-dimensional surface. They need to learn a whole array of basic, you know, simple skills, you know, that they often don't learn. Like, you know, if you're to develop a style, you know, you have to learn how to have some skill in drawing what you observe, you know, and not be stuck in imitating, you know, other people's styles, especially comic book styles. So I guess, you know, and there's a lot of controversy over this, you know, I would, you know, stress, you know, basic observational drawing, because, I mean, it's been shown in a lot of the research that everybody can learn, you know, how to draw, you know, fairly well from observation. But since that's not, I mean, art, you know, as compared to math and English, was not emphasized in American schools, you know, most of them, you know, don't come, unless they have their own, you know, unless they're naturally skilled, you know, they don't come with, you know, many skills as far as drawing or painting or any other media are concerned.
I think, you know, unfortunately art and music have been kind of neglected in an effort to kind of improve what's most important. I think folks have decided that, you know, in a kind of back to basics kind of mentality, that, you know, the important subjects didn't necessarily include art and music, even though that's, you know, I think if we go back historically.